Yes, and here is your question.
نعم.
Yes,
Okay. Yes, ma'am. I am ready.
I think it's recording. Yes. Right, so if you have read and understood, kindly tell me, can you please identify these structures from A, B, C, and D? What is this A?
Okay, this is dorsum of the right hand.
Yes.
Identify the orange area. This is anatomical snuff box. A, this is extensor bolus longus, and B, this is abductor bolus longus, and C, extensor bolus brevis.
Okay, can you please tell me what might be the significance of tenderness in the anatomical snuff box?
This is importance for the regarding case scenario pain between the thumb and the between thumb and the finger for scaphoid fracture.
Okay. Can you tell me, please, why do you have avascular necrosis of the scaphoid?
What's ma'am?
Avascular necrosis of the scaphoid bone, scaphoid fracture.
Yeah, the effect of the scaphoid fracture might lead to vascular necrosis, especially in the proximal segment due to retrograde vascular blood supply.
Okay. From where does it get its blood supply?
Yeah, the blood supply of the scaphoid from the palmar and dorsal branches of the renal artery. The palmar supply the proximal part and the supply the distal and the dorsal supply the proximal and the west. But the most part get a vascular necrosis. This is the proximal part because of the reduced collateral blood supply.
Can you please tell me how would you test the collateral circulation of the hand?
Yeah, the collateral circulation of the hand mainly from the superficial palmar branch of the ulnar artery and the superficial palmar branch of the radial artery and anastomosis together to perform a palmar arch.
Yes, but how would you test it? Which test would you do to test collateral circulation, please?
Yeah, the test, this is Allen test.
Yes, how Allen test is done, can you please explain?
Yes, the Allen test by ask the patient to waste the hand for 30 seconds and occlude the both artery, ulnar and the radial artery. And after that, release one and apply pressure on the both artery, radial and ulnar artery to occlude both. After that, still elevation and open the hand. Normally, after release the pressure over the ulnar artery, the color return in the 7 seconds. If delay more than 7 seconds, indicate ischemia of the upper limb.
Okay, good. Can you please tell me this area D is marked, area D is supplied by which dermatome?
Yeah, this is C8.
Good. Can you please tell me what you see in this diagram in label A? Can you name the bones? Identify all the bones.
This is A, this is scaphoid, B, this length of radius, D, this is lunate, E, this is ulna.
Yes. Can you name all the carpal bones?
Yeah, the carpal bone from the lateral to medial, scaphoid, lunate, trichotillon, and divisiform, and the distal from the lateral to medial, trapezium, trapezoid, carpate, and hamate.
Okay, can you please tell me what are the muscles? Can you please tell me what are the contents of an anatomical snuff box?
Yeah, the content radial artery and the radial nerve.
Okay, can you please tell me the movements of the thumb muscles?
Yeah, the thumb muscles flexion by flexor bolus longus and extensor bolus and the flexor bolus brevis, supplied by the median nerve, and the extension by the extensor bolus longus and the extensor bolus brevis. And the obonus by the obonus bolus by the median nerve, and the adduction by the adductor bolus by the supply by the ulnar nerve, and the abduction by the abductor bolus brevis by the median nerve, and the abductor bolus longus by the radial nerve.
Can you please tell me where the tendon of flexor distrum superficialis will insert, and where the on the thumb, and where the tendon flexor distrum profundus will insert?
Yeah, the flexor digitorum profundus inserted into the base of the distal of the terminal phalanges, and the flexor digitorum superficialis inserted into the proximal part of the into the middle of the proximal part of the terminal phalanges.
Okay, which dermatome can be checked to show the test for flexor distrum superficialis?
What's mom?
Which dermatome, or if you can show, demonstrate how to test what is the nerve supply of flexor distrum superficialis? So which dermatome is supplied, is supplying that muscle?
Yeah, the flexor digitorum profundus supplied by the ulnar nerve and the median nerve, and the flexor digitorum superficialis supplied by the anterior interosseous nerve of the median nerve.
Can you please tell me how the extensor retinaculum is formed or attached? Attachment of extensor retinaculum.
Yeah, the extensor retinaculum attached the laterally from the radius and the medially to the trichotillon and the trapezium, and okay. They classify to six compartments.
Okay, what are those compartments, and what tendon do they contain?
Yeah, the first compartment classified to the six compartment. First compartment extensor bolus longus and extensor bolus brevis, and the second extensor carpiradialis, and the third abductor bolus longus, and the fourth extensor digitorum, and the fifth extensor digitorum and extensor indiges, and the fifth extensor carpi anaris, and the sixth extensor and the sixth abductor digit minimi.
Okay, if I just pose on X-ray, you miss the scaphoid fracture, what are the consequences? What can happen?
Yeah, if the misdiagnosis of the scaphoid fracture can lead to a vascular necrosis of the scaphoid bone.
And anything else?
Yeah, and the arthritis and the osteomyelitis.
Yes, could it result in malunion?
Yeah.
Right, good. Thank you. Anyone? It was good. You could answer everything. Anyone else want to give feedback? Could I have asked any more questions?
Dr. Muhammad, can you repeat the extensor compartments of the wrist again?
What?
Dorsal compartment of wrist you just told right now.
Yes,
how many compartments? Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, first compartment, abductor bursis longus and extensor bursis brevis. Second, extensor carpobronchialis longus and extensor carpobronchialis brevis. The third, extensor bursis longus. And fourth, extensor digitorum and extensor indicis. And the fifth, extensor digitum minimi. And the sixth, extensor carpobronchialis.
Yes, now it's okay, good.
Yeah, now
it's okay. Actually, I think last time he said abductor digiti minimi.
That's why I asked.
Otherwise, he answered all questions, I think.
Yes, very good. Anyone else want to add anything?
Yeah.
No. Started the timer and here is your question. There is another one, this one. This is the question. Sorry. Yes. So if you have read and understood, can we begin?
Okay, ma'am. The management,
yes.
According to the ABC.
Yes.
The management according to ABC approach of the CRISPR protocol, airway assessment and the treatment, and the breathing by inspection for the symmetrical chest wall movement, and the count respiratory rate, and then palpation, and then circulation assessment and the treatment by both the two large bore cannula and the anticubital fossa, take full blood count, urine and electrolyte, and the creatinine and the blood group and the cross match. Start with the 1 bolus of the IV fluid, 1 liter of the IV of the Ringer lactate. With if not responder, can be added 1 liter of the crystalloid. With monitor the patient with the blood pressure and pulse and urine output and the mental status. Regarding the case scenario, my professional diagnosis could be acute relapsing pancreatitis, could be a chronic pancreatitis, could be acute cholecystitis, could be a syndicolangitis, could be pancreatic pseudocyst.
Okay, good. Can you please tell me why the patient might be tachypneic?
Yes, because of the patient in tachypneic, because of the abdominal pain due to sympathetic stimulation, and it could be pressure by the pseudocyst, and it could be due to adult respiratory distress syndrome.
Good. Can you tell me what is the pathogenesis of acute pancreatitis?
Yeah, the pathogenesis of the acute pancreatitis due to pancreatic duct obstruction led to reflux of the bile into the pancreatic duct, cause injury and decrease in intraductal pressure, led to damage of the pancreatic. After damage of the pancreatic, acini led to release of the pancreatic enzyme. Due to virus or bacteria or trauma or drugs. After enzyme, pancreatic enzyme released like protease cause widespread destruction of pancreas, and the enzyme release led to more damage. And the lipase release cause fat necrosis result, which flicks white on pancreas and the omentum with the fat deposition due to calcium deposition. And due to the elastase enzyme lead to the greater sign, and the hemorrhage can be lead to extensive and acute hemorrhagic pancreatitis.
Good. Can you tell me about the Glasgow criteria?
Yeah, the Glasgow criteria dependent to 10 component, like pressure oxygen if the less than 8, LH more than 50.
Yes.
Yes, pressure oxygen less than 8 kPa and the age more than 55, and the calcium less than 2 millimole after 48 hours, and the neutrophil more than 15, and the LDH more than 600 after 48 hours, and the urea more than 16 millimole, and the blood glucose more than 10 millimole, and the albumin less than 3 gram after 48. At least 3 of this component indicate severe acute myocarditis and indicate admission in the ICU.
Very good. Okay. In this acute pancreatitis, patient often have hypocalcemia. What might be the causes?
Yes, the hypocalcemia in patient with acute pancreatitis as early due to autodigestion of the mesenteric fat by pancreatic enzyme lead to release of the free fatty acid, which form calcium salt, and the secondary may be due to transient hypoparathyroidism and hypomagnesemia. And the later stage due to complication of the acute pancreatitis by the sepsis lead to increase circulation of the catecholamine. The catecholamine cause shift of the circulating calcium into the intracellular compartment lead to relative hypocalcemia and hypomagnesemia.
Okay. To stratify the risks of acute pancreatitis, there are several criteria. Can you name few? The
scoring systems. Criteria. Yes. Yeah, money scoring system could be ransom criteria and dependent on the criteria for admission and after 40 hours, and there could be Baltazar CT scan scoring criteria to assist the severity of the acute pancreatitis on the CT scan imaging.
In this patient, serum amylase is 3400. Which enzyme should you test?
The serum amylase and not specific in the acute pancreatitis, the lipase more specific because the normal amylase return back to the normal level after 48 hours from the onset of the attack, and does not correlate with severity of the pancreatitis and not specific for the pancreatitis.
Can you specific, name? Lipase.
More specific. Okay. Lipase and the LDH.
All right. Can you please name two situations in which in acute pancreatitis, serum amylase level tends to be normal?
Yes, after acute attack after 48 hours can be too early or too late.
Okay. Top and in the top of chronic pancreatitis application. Okay, all right. Yeah, can you name few complications if acute pancreatitis cannot be managed? What are the complications?
The acute pancreatitis multi-systemic complication would be local and systemic. As local lead to pseudo cyst, abscess, necrotizing pancreatitis, fat necrosis. And the splenic vein thrombosis, and on the GIT system, gastrointestinal ileus and the bleeding, and on the renal system lead to acute renal failure and the hematological DIC and the hepatobiliary portal vein thrombosis and the stricture and jaundice and the systemic hypovolemic shock and hemorrhagic shock and the serous and multi-organ failure and the metabolic complication like hypocalcemia, hypomagnesemia, hypoalbuminemia, hyperglycemia, hypoxemia, and respiratory arrest, and pleural effusion.
Very good. Can you please tell me how would you manage the nutrition in acute pancreatitis?
Yeah, the management of the nutrition. TPN is usually needed in the severe case. Recently, the growth in the world, the institution early feeding with the nasogenal.
Okay, good. If you suspect patient has pseudocyst, how would you? Yes, if you suspect patient has pseudocyst, how would you diagnose it? How would you do? Yes, diagnosis of pseudocyst.
Yes, the pseudocyst different. This is a collection of the amylase rich fluid in the wall of the fibrous or granulation tissue, result after 4 weeks and from the onset of the attack, can be diagnosed if the persistent of the amylase more than 4 weeks. This is one of the indicate of the diagnosis of the pseudocyst. And also the pseudocyst not closed and do not have lining of the epithelial cells separating from the nearby tissue. And that can be if the take carcinic and embryonic antigen level is normal and the amylase level can be increased and persistent and the fluid viscosity low in the pseudocyst and elevated in the another cyst.
Okay, good. What are the complications that can result because of the presence of pseudocyst?
Yeah, complication could be rupture into the bowel and peritoneum, bleeding, infection, cholangitis, portal vein thrombosis, and common bile duct obstruction.
Very good. Okay. How should pseudocyst be managed?
Yeah, the management after history and examination, like ultrasound and the MRCP and the CT scan and the fluid analysis, 40% of acute pseudocyst resolve within 1 week.
Very good. Okay, bell has gone, but the last question. Usually patients with acute pancreatitis have severe pain. How would you propose to manage the pain of this patient?
Can be give mild opioid like codeine. If not respond to mild opioid, can be give strong opioid like BCA and epidural analgesia.
Okay, thank you. Bell is already gone, but then now, yeah. Yes, anyone else want to add anything? I'm sorry, I got disconnected in the middle. When I asked the question, then I got disconnected. All right, good. One little feedback, Dr. Mohammed. When I'm asking question, I allow you to speak. But then when in exam, when you know all the answers and you're answering like a bullet, like you're answering now, examiner may interrupt you and then they will ask you the next question. And then when you ask, can you please, oh, Dr. Mohammed got disconnected, ask directly to answer the question to the point instead of like giving the whole story. That's all I had to say.
Yes, ma'am. Muhammad have some problem about understanding.